Hey, Book Club, Dan here from One Man Book Club with Serafina and the Black Cloak. Actually, this is the entire Serafina series. There's four books in the series. Book one is Serafina and the Black Cloak. Book two, Serafina and the Twisted Staff. Book three, Serafina and the Splintered Heart. And book four, Serafina and the Seven Stars. Now, this book is going to be great for any of you who maybe like creepy fun. If you have preteens at your house or you like middle grade yourself, I think you might enjoy Serafina. My 11-year-old now has a new all-time favorite series. Serafina hit all of the right notes for my kiddo. I mean, she plowed through it faster, plowed through all four books actually, faster than she's ever read anything. So, huge win for Serafina, and really, I can just stop this review right there, because if the kids like it, then that's all we need to know. But I didn't love Serafina the first time I read it back in 2017, just the first book. But of course, my daughter wanted me to read it with her so we could talk about it, and you know, you can't really say no to that. So I reread book one and then forced myself to keep going. You know, the things we do for our kids. Unfortunately, I didn't love book one the second time any more than the first, but I stuck with it because of the kid and because I often find that I settle into a series after a first book letdown as I get used to the author's style and get invested in the characters. But sadly, no, not this time. No luck there. I actually struggled reading books two, three, and four in the same ways I struggled with book one. I mean, the main characters has this mountain girl voice. Super grating, really hard to read, really uncomfortable to read for me. The narrative voice wasn't very consistent. The problems in the series aren't plausible with the story, and the solutions are just overly simplistic. The bad guys are truly creepy, but there is a really, like, I was shocked by the unexpected intensity to the violence in the story, believe it or not. That really made me cringe. If it hadn't been for my solemn dad word of honor, I probably would have bailed sometime around book two. But, huge but, the fact that my young reader was so gripped in the story and the characters, it can't be ignored. I mean, she loved the mystery, the relationship, the magic. She loved the historical elements too, because the book is set in the Biltmore Mansion, in the turn of the century, all of its turn of the century glory. And yeah, that does add some fun fuel for the imagination. There's definitely something here. And you need to make sure that you don't let my grown-up boy dad opinion discourage other young readers who would enjoy imaginative magical mystery trip into history like my young reader did. There's absolutely no grown-up stuff to be concerned about here, but parents should know, like I said, that these books are dark and scary. The bad guys are creepy. And those, the violence, it's about, it's animals attacking people. And it's pretty intense through all four books. Mountain lions and dogs biting people on the neck and dragging them around. And anyway, it was pretty scary. My daughter and I talked about it. She wasn't deterred, but your sensitive reader might be. Now, I give the series 4 stars. My daughter gave it 5 blazing stars. So we're going to meet in the middle and give Serafina together 4 stars. I wanted to get her on video to come give a video review, but I couldn't get her to do that. But she did write me a review that's out on One Man Book Club. So if you want to read her review of the Serafina series, go over there and check it out. Otherwise, best for 10 and up, as long as you're okay with the spookiness. Happy reading, everyone.